वेलकम टू आवर चैनल केम अचीवर्स। आई एम प्रनिश। टुडे वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, इट इज़ कॉल्ड रिएक्टिव इंटरमीडिएट्स। एक्चुअली आई हैव टू स्टार्ट दिस रिएक्टिव इंटरमीडिएट्स। द फर्स्ट रिएक्टिव इंटरमीडिएट्स आई हैव चूजन, इट इज़ कॉल्ड कार्बिन। दिस इज कॉल्ड कार्बिन केमिस्ट्री। मोस्टली द कार्बिन केमिस्ट्री नॉट ए बिग ऑर्गेनिक रिएक्टिव इंटरमीडिएट्स, इट इज़ लिटिल बिट within our capability. I will explain mainly important whatever example here I chosen that is related to your NUT exam, because previously whatever I took class about this or organic chemistry, I have chosen the mostly important example which came already in NUT exam. And carbene come from carbon, okay. This carbene is one type of reactive intermediates, because it is called reactive intermediates because of in situ some reaction it will generate and it will trap or attract some other moiety and it will give some product. So in reaction it will generate, not after before generate or after, it will time length is very less. So in situ it will generate. Sometimes scientists will trap these intermediates. There are many more intermediates, you already know, radicals, nitrines, carbocation, carbon anion also there. Like that it is carbene. Carbene means it is not a negative charge or not a positive charge, not a radical or not a any other thing. It is look different. Here it will represent here in by dot, two dot. Because this is why it is wrong. If two dot is there, we will write that minus. But it is why it will write two dot, because that electrons are moving in their orbital, different orbital in carbon. It will only generate in carbon. In carbon, it will moving there. In carbon, different p orbital is there. It will moving. So first we learn to how it will generate the carbene. One example I took, because it is not come, but sometime you have to build your knowledge, you have to see, or sometime maybe in exam it will come. See, generation of carbene, I took this ketone and I use tosyl hydrazine and methoxide, that will form. See, I use this ketone and that will form, okay. Then this it will form na? Then base function is like that. Base will take this proton and here minus will come, and here it is there, it will come and it will out. So this is form in reaction, it will like that. And if you give, this is one azotype compound, azo compound is there, diazo compound is form. This diazo after heating it will give this intermediate. I will not write here like if two dot is there, everyone prepares in our classes BSc, you will say the let minus. No, never root minus. If minus, it is carbon anion, because this electron is distinguishable electron. It shows some in case of some carbene, it will show some paramagnetic behavior. So this we will write that is two dot. So that is the main of generation of carbene. Whenever you see this kind of as a compound, if you give to heat, it will definitely generate carbene. And I will explain the different different generation of carbene by example. So example process I will one by one discuss, okay. And organic reaction, this carbene reactive intermediates are two types generally, for your knowledge you have to know, okay. See, in your carbene it will come, see, this is singlet carbene and this is called triplet carbene, okay. I wrote here triplet, might not write here singlet, but you have to understand this is singlet I wrote there, okay. So this is singlet carbene. Why it is called singlet? Because spin is one, lowest, that's why I wrote here spin is lowest one. If you haven't used the rule of spin number, that you got a spin is one, so that's why it is singlet. Here it will triplet because two unpaired electron is there, and that's why it will call triplet. And see, here is two difference. Sometime some question paper in some exam or different PSU exam, I saw some questions, they will ask the spin or orbital of this triplet. Triplet carbene has a both electron spin was same direction and different orbital. this is p one p orbital, sp orbital, and one is simple p orbital. Okay, this is sp orbital and this is p orbital. And in this case, only p orbital electron is not there. Only sp orbital, both electron with different spins are there. Okay, so that is the main thing. In I will explain another thing here. If this triplet carbene is if triplet carbene is generated by any reaction, it will go further, go to bond rotation and forming different spin of these two electrons and undergo reaction. And in this case, the both different spin just shifted one electron, thus using this electron directly. Not an rotation of bond is not necessary. In this case, rotation of bond necessary because of their spin orientation is same. And they will rotate the bond and their spin orientation will be reversed, and that time it will go. So it is step is more. So generally reaction all will go through singlet way. Okay, now I will give another example. In this example, you will be distinguish the reaction between singlet carbene and triplet carbene. I know you already see this reaction in your university or colleges also. If it is college part portion, carbene is there, though you will get this example definitely every time it will go the question paper. And if you are university, that is common. So again, I will explain. You already know these things, but I will explain. See, here this H nu will generate, here this is the moiety, SR moiety, and you get two products. One is 65, this cis conformation, and one is trans conformation, trans, you got 35. So this is the two product, because I only differentiate because one triplet reaction, triplet carbene reaction I will show here. So here H nu, it will remove and give what, give some carbene. That carbene is okay. Then if it is singlet way, if it is, and in this case what happened, both bond will clip like this symmetric way, and this methyl, so this is cause of triplet, this is singlet, and it will be singlet or triplet, it will attack. Okay, and it will come like that, you can see here, and it will like that, methyl, then here one and here one, and that will come because this carbene orientation is different, it will come. But if it is from like that carbene, it is a triplet carbene, so it is a triplet carbene, so it will, bond rotation will happen in cis manner, it will form bond rotation will happen, it is triplet carbene, then this type of orientation you have to show. Okay, and it will go to this type, this trans. So this is the normal difference, you already know, and you have any doubt regarding this, you will go to your basic books and you will check. But most importantly, I will go through the most important example of carbene chemistry that you have to know. Now I will start. I write two examples about the application of carbene chemistry. Okay, now first example, you see this is as a compound, and this is some rhodium metal. Okay, so previously I have told that generation of carbene, if any azo group is there and if you use some rhodium metal, any form of rhodium metal, that will generate carbene from azo at the position of azo group. So in this case, here is azo group is there, you already know, and this rhodium you can use, and this will form what, this carbene. Okay, then this will go to here, hydrogen is there, that is called, here it will come in their cyclic way, and it is called CH insertion. Okay, CH insertion, rhodium catalyzed CH insertion happen via carbene reactive intermediates. Okay, so this is CH insertion. This type of example, every time I saw some of the step of 4 marks question in NET exam, they will give in one step CH insertion, they will give in many times in December or June type questions, they will give every time. I saw my question paper according to my knowledge. So this, and this also, this is same CH insertion is there, here oxygen and hydrogen is there. So in presence of rhodium catalyst, this will happen.
So what will be the product? This will. This is the major product. Actually, another product will be formed, but in case it is major, so major also they will give, and it also major product. So this is the application of CH carbon chemistry, and this carbon will generated by rhodium metal, and CH insertion will happen. So this is the two example. You study carefully. Next example. Here another two example are shown there. See. This is called previously we study about CH insertion. Now here CO insertion, CO or O insertion, we also told CO insertion, and here it will call NC insertion. Okay, because NC insertion, you know. This is N insertion and this is CO insertion. See here, I already told as a group is there, rhodium is there, carbon will generate here. Okay, carbon will generate here, and that oxygen will attack, and this will be the form, and this is the major product. So this is one example of oxygen insertion. Previously CS you already saw. Now here it is NC. Here see, another as a group is there and rhodium is there. Okay, then what is there? Then it is this, and that will here come. So this is like that. This example came in some gate exam recently, 2018 maybe. This example came, they are giving 2 marks about this exam. So this is the mostly important example. Again it will repeat because this type of examples only there. So it is oxygen insertion and this is nitrogen insertion. Now I'll go to another two examples of example I chose. The utilization of carbon chemistry in organic synthesis. So here you will see this alcohol and this double bond is there, no? You already see. So here I used diethyl iodate, zinc copper couple, and ether. So this reagent is called, or this reaction condition is called Simon Smith cyclopropanation reaction. Okay, this is called, this condition is, one name reaction is there, it is called Simon Smith cyclopropanation reaction. Okay, in this you have to see, na, see, cyclopropane ring will form everywhere, and this will go through by carbon intermediate in situ. It will generate carbon. That carbon will form cyclopropane ring with double bond. And main important thing in this reaction is there, the chelation effect of adjacent group is mostly important.